Hello and welcome. I am Grafana Champion and co-founder of Volca Flaps. On this channel, we explore non-conventional ways of using Grafana, where Grafana goes far beyond observability with the help of tools such as a business suite plugin collection. At this point, the open source business suite collection includes 10 plugins. The business table is the last to join the collection, which was just this past September. However, we're already able to report a very well-pronounced community interest. We know it based on the constantly growing number of downloads, the amount of positive comments and messages we receive, and the number of change requests on our GitHub repository. We are glad that Volca Flaps can close some gaps in Grafana functionality and bring even more confidence and overall product satisfaction to Grafana users. In this video, I give an overview of the latest business table plugin version 1.9.0. This version includes significant functionality improvements, and I cannot wait to tell you about them. Are you ready? Let's go! The purpose of the business table panel is evident from its name. It allows you to visualize your data in a table format. To have access to all the features I'm going to demonstrate today, please ensure you have the business table panel at least version 1.9.0. Starting from this version, you can add a row, delete a row, and edit data in a row. You can also have nested objects. It is when one cell contains multiple values. These values can be stored in the same data source as your general table data or in any other data source. For instance, nested objects can be statuses of an order. So one row of your table is one order. And then here you can display all statuses sorted by the date they changed. You can add a new status, modify an existing, or delete any status. The business table has extensive permission configuration. For example, an operator can add a new status, but only a supervisor can modify or delete it. In the business table 1.9.0, we added more data types to display data. The Boolean type. When displayed, it looks like a circle with or without a check mark. The image type. It can interpret the Base64 format or a link. The preformatted type. It is similar to the HTML tag PRE. It displays your text with breaks and spaces preserved. Optionally, you can display it in the fixed width font or a default browser font. The rich text type. It will display your HTML or Markdown. We also added two editor types. One is switch. It works well with the Boolean display type and looks like a standard Grafana switch UI element. The text area is convenient in the event of large text that a user is expected to work with. Now let's dive into the specific of configuration. First, I prepare a data frame. I connect my business table panel to the business input data source. It's my favorite data source for generating dummy data. I describe all the columns I want. The city column with the string type, the date column time type, the metric value number type, and the verified Boolean type. After the field description, I have two choices. Use JavaScript mode and populate a data frame programmatically, or manually enter all rows. This is what I do here. With this data frame, I am ready to start configuring the business table panel. So, the most significant change in the business table version 1.9.0 is the ability to add and delete a row. We organized all parameters into 7 almost independent categories to make the panel configuration more user-friendly. Schematically, I envisioned the configuration sequence like this. Here you can see the main steps and their order. The first step is the layout parameter category. Here I specify the look of my table for end users. This is the look they have when they review data. I can create multiple tabs. Enter a name, tab 1, then add button, tab 2, then add button, tab 3, then again the add button. On the panel, 3 tabs appear. Next, on every tab, I add columns from the available data frames. Let's say here I want the city column, the date column, the metric, and the verified. After that, I can expand every column for configuration. Leave the type as auto if you are not sure yet what type you need. I change the type for the verified column, set it to the Boolean. With that, on the panel, I get the circle with or without the check mark inside. I demonstrated most of the parameters that you can set in the layout category in this video. They are all pretty self-explanatory, except maybe this one, the grouping. Use grouping to create tree view layouts. Here for the city column, when I set group to yes, the collapse expand icon appear on the panel. All values, all identical values are placed into one group. In my case, I have groups made of city names. When at least one column is set to be a group, the rest of the columns have this new parameter called aggregation, where I specify a math function, mean, max, etc. to calculate the group value. In my example, the value of the metric for all devices in one city. I set it to average. Let's look back at the parameter setup flow. After the layout, I can configure the add data. When I open it, I see all the tabs I added to the layout. If I want to allow row editing on a tab, I need to switch these two on. With that, down below, all existing columns appear. To enable a user to populate data in a particular column, I need to turn the switch to on. Some columns like ID or current date are usually populated by the database, so there is no need for user access. After I allow a user to populate a column, I need to select the editor type. The editor type determines a UI element that a user works with to add new data. As you can see, the list is different and independent of the types you specify in the layout. The switch is a good example of different types in action. Here is the Boolean data type when business table is open for review, and here is the switch editor type, which is used when a user works on populating a new row. Another interesting editor type is select. It can be populated from any data source and give a user a predetermined list of values to choose from. Optionally, you can allow custom values. If this switch is on, a user can enter a value from a keyboard. The icon to add a row looks like a plus in the table header. It appears when the add data functionality is allowed to at least one column on the tab. Please note that the icon appears in the table header, so to access it, the show header should be set to true in the layout section. Let me click on this plus. Here a new row appears and the user can populate it. These columns are ready to be populated and those are off limits because I did not turn the switch on for them. The next step is to configure the data source where a new data row will be saved along with a query. In my example, I have the following. After that, I can configure permission, or in other words, who is allowed to add rows on my panel. The choices are always allowed or determined by the Grafana's role with the selection of which role exactly. And the third choice is by the backend, which means a value that comes from the data source. If the value comes as true, permission is given. If the value comes as false, permission is not given. Let's check back the schema. The next is to configure the edit data. It is similar to add data configuration. First, I specify which tabs should allow the data editing, then which columns and in what type the column should be edited. The editor type selection is the same as for the add data. Then I specify the data source and query and determine the permission. All right, let's check the schema again. The next step is the delete data. Similar to add and edit data, delete data is a separate configuration. I start by specifying which tabs allow an end user to delete a row by switching here to on. Once I do, those icons appear on every row of my table. Here I need to specify a data source and a query to be executed when a user clicks on the delete a row button. In permission, I can specify who is allowed to delete a row. Next on my schema is nested objects. Now let's go over how to configure it. I start in the layout category, where I specify the type column nested objects. Then in the category nested objects, I work on the get options parameter, where I specify the data source and the query to fetch the values. That means that the nested objects might come from a different data source than the one where your data for a table is stored. After that, I need to set up the card. It's the only available type for now. I populate the elements I want to be displayed for every nested object. For instance, in the query, I retrieve those fields and then I populate the column names here. The get option configures what the nested objects look like when a user reviews the table. Optionally, you can allow add options by switching here. Also, the edit and delete options here respectively. On the panel, an end user can click here and the drawer with all the information related to this cell nested objects appears. An end user can access add, delete, and add actions in that drawer. All three actions have configurable permission with a logic similar to that of the general data permission. You can specify a Grafana's row or a column in your data source with a Boolean value. That is all for the parameter flow configuration. You can always refer to the plugin documentation to read more about it and find actual examples. In addition to the flow, I wanted to share more examples of what the business table panel can do for you. Here, the row background is highlighted following the thresholds. Alternatively, it can be a font text or only one cell highlighted. You can allow to download data in the CSV format. The tree view layout can be combined with nested objects. You can combine the business table with the business variable panel as I show here. The business table data follows the selected status on the business variable panel. For a significant volume of data, you can set up server-based pagination. The server-based pagination is excellent for performance since not all data rows are retrieved, only the current page. A row can be a link or multiple links. Links can lead to external resources or other Grafana dashboards. Your table can display images coming as Base64 or as a link. Please refer to my release blog post describing all new features. And do not forget the business table plugin documentation. We maintained very well. Let us know what you think about this plugin. Leave questions, provide a brief description of your use cases, and suggest what can be improved in the plugin to help more community users. This is all for now. Thank you for watching and see you next time.